Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Apa khabar semua? Bersama saya Chef Ammar dan my main sponsor Saudagar Kurma, Feel the Fresh. Hari ini insyaallah kita nak masak yang makanan sedap. Kita nak buat lasagna. Tapi bukan any lasagna. This one is going to be thought to you the original way and the fantastic way. Bahan-bahan dia banyak senang, banyak mudah. Semua barang-barang ada di market di Malaysia. Kita ada minced beef, kita ada lasagna sheet, we have onion, we have mushroom, we have tomato paste. You can find it at Saudagar Kurma outlet, and if you are going back kampung, you can find it in TBS, Terminal Bus Station. We have garlic and we have oregano, rosemary and thyme, three herbs. Okay, we have mozzarella cheese, parmesan cheese, milk, butter and flour. Kemudian kita nak start insyaallah with the roux. Okay, please make sure when you do the lasagna, make sure that your roux is white color, not brown color. So kita tak mau apa, kita tak mau bagi flour kita jadi warna hitam or gelap or our butter. Make sure that your butter is room temperature. See how I'm cutting it? I'm cutting it with my spatula, wooden one, or wooden spoon. Make sure that your fire is not too high, slow, because I do not want it to brown my butter. Tamau jadi my butter, saya tamau my butter jadi apa? Gelap warna. Kalau kita taruh 100 gram, kita taruh 100 gram. Kalau kita taruh 50 gram butter, kita taruh 50 gram of flour. Lepas tu, you tak payah cool it down because we are going to cook straight. Milk and cooking cream, half and half. Kita taruh sedikit. Okay. We stir it nicely and we combine everything. See? Now become very heavy. So once become very heavy, what I need to do? I will add more milk and cream. I need to have a little bit of water standby. Kita continue stirring and working it out to make sure that our roux become very smooth. See, now become a bit heavier. Look at this. Become heavy, right? So what we will do now, we'll add a little bit of water. See, now become very thick, right? Because everything being already worked out already, right? But I'm not going to use this kind of roux. I need to add more water. See, we have to feel and we have to see. Look at this. Become very smooth. So what I will do now, I will add a little bit of parmesan cheese just to enhance my roux. And I will put a little bit of salt just to make sure that everything is seasoned accordingly. Don't worry about the recipe, inshallah, I will be giving it to you after we finish the cooking at the end of the program. Okay, alhamdulillah, ni bechamel sudah siap. You cannot be patient lah, kita kena sabar bila kita buat ni bechamel. Okay, bila bechamel sudah siap, kita taruh asing at the side. Dan sekarang kita nak masak apa? Kita nak masak daging kita punya lah. Kita ambil satu periuk, my favorite periuk. Selalu orang bila buat lasagna, dia nak potong daging, dan daging bila kita ambil taruh atas plate, dia sudah collapse. The reason is because you are not putting enough bechamel in your meat mixture. This is a very important tip. Not everybody can teach you this one. It is all behind the scene. But bersama saya Chef Ammar dan Saudagar Kurma, insyaAllah kita nak kongsi bersama anda macam mana kita nak buat yang cantik punya. Insya Rabbil Alamin. Kita taruh 80 ml minyak zaitun. Chef Ammar punya boleh dapat di Saudagar Kurma. Kita ambil onion. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Kita ambil garlic. Slice, no problem. Dan kita ambil our herbs. is the herbs here. Then bit rosemary. Bit dia macam ni. One steam of oregano and one steam of thyme. Okay, kita ambil ni lah thyme. Dan kita chop. Masya Allah, once you chop it, all the aroma comes up so beautiful, you know. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Do not leave anything. Start to mix one more time. Pack all the herbs. Take the minced beef. Kita kacau semua, stir it nicely to make sure that everything is evenly cooked. Kita ambil tomato paste. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dalam satu tin. No problem. Most of the people like to put sugar. I don't like to put sugar. This one will be a fantastic lasagna, inshallah, for all of you today. Okay. Kita ambil mushroom. Kalau you tak mau taruh mushroom, suka hati you. No problem at all. Dan garam. Ini sadaqah lah. Kita sudah biasa sama sadaqah, alhamdulillah, dalam makanan. Dan kita ambil mixed veggie dalam half packet. No problem at all. Don't worry, inshallah, the recipe will be given to all of you bersama Chef Ammar and Saudagar Kurma at the end of the program. Kita kena taruh air sedikit saja, around 5 tablespoon. We kacau everything. Yang penting tip sekarang jadi. Kita ambil bechamel sauce. Satu. Kita ambil bechamel sauce. Dua. Dan don't forget the sadaqah. Okay. I off my fire now because I do not want it to cook my filling lasagna for too long because we are going to put it inside the oven. So what will happen, Ni? When I put the bechamel sauce, yes, the color will change, but bechamel sauce will make the meat and the vegetable, everything and the liquid intact. So bila kita potong, you angkat, nampak cantik. You taruh dalam atas plate, 2 minit, dia sudah flat out. So, the bechamel sauce, insyaAllah, will be holding it. The color been changed already. No problem. I off my fire. Now, that's it. My lasagna, my bechamel already been done. Now, we will be telling you how to assemble your lasagna sheet on your baking tray. Don't go anyway, stay bersama saya, Chef Ammar. Okay, alhamdulillah, bechamel kita sudah siap dan lasagna filling sudah siap. Sekarang kita ada mozzarella dan kita ada parmesan. Now we have lasagna sheet. Saya tak pernah boil my lasagna sheet dalam air dan angkat dan taruh. Ini to me banyak leceh, nanti dia pecah ke tak pecah ke ni semua. Saya ambil ni as it is, hard, dry, I put it here. It is very thin layer. Lasagna kita sekarang ni, dia ada cukup moist. Bechamel kita, dia ada cukup moist. So, kita tak payah buang masa nak boil, rebus, sheet ni. Dan kita nak kena angkat, kita kena taruh tuala, kita kena taruh atas tuala pula. Banyak handling lah, nanti dia pecah banyak. So, ikut saya insyaAllah, saya bagi you yang ilmu yang baik, ikhlas dari hati saya. Okay. Kita taruh sheet, satu, dua. Dan kita taruh sini. Eh, chef, ni ada sikit gap. Sini ada sikit gap. Jangan risau. Ini bila dia sudah masak, dia expand by itself. Because this one is already not been moist yet. Bila dia moist, dia jadi besar sikit. Alright. So, jangan risau bersama kami, insya Rabbil Alamin. Ha? So, what we will do, we'll take this one. Technique. Take here. Tak payah taruh full. Sedikit saja. Okay. Masya Allah. Sedap lah. Now tengok. Bersama saya nak teach you another technique. Kita ambil ni, kita taruh kan. Kita ambil ni, kita taruh kan. Kita tekan sekarang. Tengok macam mana saya level. Macam kontraktor pula. Ha. Kita ambil ni kan. Tengok. Eh chef ni tak ada, ini tak ada. Jangan risau. Kita ambil dan kita tekan sikit. Semua. Begin at the edges lah. Okay. So sekarang kita buat apa? Buat satu layer. Tengok macam mana. Saya ikut. Ah, ha? Saya ikut lasagna sheet now. Teknik number three. Kita ikut lasagna sheet. Okay, kita kena kemas. Terus bila kita nak taruh ni dalam oven, kita tak mahu ni jadi apa? Bakarlah. Ambil ni. Ambil ni. Sedikit sini. Okay. Saya tekan sendiri. Taruh sini. We have a different spoon for us to work with the bechamel. Betul tak? Bechamel. Saya taruh sini. Saya taruh sini. Ha, tengok macam mana kita buat. Saya taruh sini. Sini. Dan kita taruh sini. Tip number 4. You tak payah. Bagi dia level up. Don't worry about it. Once it's cooking, everything will be flat out. The temperature will be doing the job. So what I will do, I tekan sini. Okay. Dan kita apa buat? Kita ambil ni, tengok. Macam kontraktor pula. Tekan sini. Mozzarella cheese, parmesan cheese, mana you nak taruh, jangan risau. Kita boleh ambil dan kita boleh taruh atas ni. Okay? Tak ada masalah. Alright. Ini tak ada masalah. Kita ambil mozzarella cheese sikit dan kita taruh sini. Okay. Ini tip nombor 5. Kira-kira. Tip nombor 5. Kita nak taruh mana pun tak apa. Tengok. Saya ambil. Saya taruh 1. Saya taruh 2. Taruh 3. Masya Allah. Bila you buat ni di rumah, please bagi I tahu dalam Facebook saya, boleh ambil gambar, boleh share sama saya dan kita boleh share sama semua sahabat-sahabat kita. Okey, pasal apa saya taruh macam ni? So saya boleh potong sini, dia ada 2 biji already. Saya boleh potong sini, dia ada 2 biji also lah. Okey. Ikutkan. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin. Kita ambil bechamel. Tekan sikit-sikit pun tak apa. You nak buat style I, suka hati. You nak buat style you, the most important thing that you learn the basic. So kita ambil lagi satu. Banyak orang nak pecah lasagna sheet dan nak buat just cantik, ram-ram. Soon to the tray itself lah. You can find tray designed for lasagna sheet. No problem at all. In the market ada lah. Okay. Kita ambil lasagna. Okay. You nak tukar, boom boleh. Tapi saya tak mau. Saya start macam ni. Saya buat macam ni juga. Okay. Ha, dah lupa pula. Okay. Kalau you lupa, jangan risau. Boleh angkat dan boleh taruh cheese. You suka cheese kan? Tapi don't put too much lah. Ha? Nanti you feel very heavy. Ini bukan mac and cheese. Alright. So kita taruh balik. Tak ada masalah. Kalau ni basah kita nak angkat, banyak susah. Betul-betul banyak susah. So ibu-ibu di rumah, ibu nak belajar pun bersama saya, tak ada masalah. Now see, saya tekan. Tengok. Sekarang kita tekan. Because I want to do the last layer. Okay. See? You see the layers now there? How? They're all beautiful, right? Betul tak? So sekarang kita buat apa? Kita nak buat the last layer. Either you do what they call it, the meat sauce first, and you finish it with the bechamel, or you do the bechamel and you finish it with the meat sauce. Saya suka taruh meat sauce dulu. Bismillah. Tengok. Sekarang saya boleh buat because everything been tak boleh dari sini sana. Tip number 6 already. Okay, tengok. Bring other side. See here. Cameraman, please take. Tengok sini. Kalau kita nak beli lasagne outside, satu piece berapa? RM19. Kadang-kadang RM25. Kalau KLCC, RM35. Kita ambil ni. Kita kacau sama dia sikit. Tak ada masalah. Chef, tak cukup. Bukan tak cukup. Sudah cukup, Alhamdulillah. Okay, tengok. Now, I want to teach you another tip. One more tip, what we are going to do for you. I like my binky bowl here. Sometimes kita suka buat apa? Noodle. Okay. Kita scrap. Okay. Tip number 7. Bagi dia basah. Tengok macam mana dia smooth. Oh, chef. Sudah kenal lah lasagne macam mana ni? Jangan risau. Because ini face, kita nak taruh cheese. Kita nak cover semua. Yang penting sekali, kita apa? Kita layer yang cantik. So, I hope you learn a lot with me. Alhamdulillah, kita sudah kongsi ilmu bersama anda macam mana kita nak buat lasagne yang cantik punya. Okay. Kita ambil ni, taruh sini. Ini taruh sini. Okay. Sekarang kita buat apa? Taruh parmesan cheese. So beautiful, you know. Bila kita nak bake anything in the oven with the Pyrex, please make sure that you clean at the side. Alright? Because nanti ni dia sudah bakar because temperature very high, right? Kita ambil mozzarella cheese. Dan we sprinkle everything here. You have to make sure that your mozzarella is not room temperature. Kita tak mahu mozzarella lembek. Tips number 8. Mesti mozzarella dia sejuk. Bukan sujuk sampai batu, tak. Sujuk, you can handle it. Because mozzarella very easy to get very sticky. Okay? Try to cover everything. If you have enough. Think so, we have enough. No problem at all. Now, tengok I buat apa. I tekan sama dia. Dari hati, with iman. Tekan with love. Kalau orang nak belajar macam mana nak buat lasagne, kena bayar banyak duit lah. RM500 ke, RM600 ke, kita bagi free dalam YouTube insya-Allah rabbil alamin. Okey, alhamdulillah rabbil alamin, kita sudah buat lasagne yang 5 star punya untuk semua. We will bake it in the oven 180 degree 40 minutes to 35 minutes depends on your oven. Sometimes take 50 minutes. So it's always depends on your oven. From time to time you have to check your lasagne if it is really being cooked 40 minutes with the convention oven lah. Okay. So, don't go anywhere. Stay bersama saya, Chef Ammar. Masak dari hati. Masak with iman. Dan saudagar kurma. Feel the fresh. We will be continue with another recipe. Okay, sekarang kita nak buat yang minuman hebat sikit. Kita ada pineapple, nanas. Kita ada orange, yellow lemon, pudina, kurma madu. Gula tak ada. Dan lemon ni itu yang garnishing lah. Tapi sebelum kita start, tolong spare sama saya 2 minit kita nak cakap pasal kurma. Okey, kurma ni first of all it is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam sunnah makan. Alright. For example, kita ada Majdul, kita ada Ajwa, kita ada Riyami, kita ada macam-macam brand, kita ada macam-macam nama, kita ada macam-macam climate. Tapi ni kurma nak cakap macam mana? Bila kita puasa, tenaga tak ada. Our level sugar sudah turun. Long day, we are working, we are fasting. we are praying, we are doing all these things. Bila kita buka puasa, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam dia suka buka puasa bersama kurma, because kurma ni cepat-cepat dia bagi sugar in the blood naik. Ini nombor satu. Nombor dua, dia boleh bagi kami recharge balik, take our tenaga balik. Dan ni kurma ada banyak, banyak gula, boleh digest dalam setengah jam. Allahu alam. Ini apa yang kita sudah baca dalam artikel lah. Okay. Ini kurma juga ada kaya with vitamins, with proteins, with minerals, with ions, with vitamins, vitamin B1, B2, B3, B6, B9. We have also in this kurma some AI. So, tolong, puasa ke tak puasa ke, boleh makan kurma ni. Because kurma ni ada gula, kita boleh digest dalam setengah jam sahaja. The sugar in this kurma can be digested only in half an hour. See, manfaat kita boleh dapat banyak mana. Other gula, kalau kita nak makan, it will take at least 4 hours to be digested. Subhanallah. Makanan dalam Al-Quran Karim, makanan sunnah Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you boleh makan during Ramadan, you boleh makan during normal month lah. It's not an issue at all. So therefore, Saudagar Kurma have a lot of variety of kurma. You can go over there and you can have a look and you can please your eyes, whatever you want to buy. I want to try with this one. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Majdul betul-betul sedap dari Palestin. Okay. We will start with our pineapple. Put inside about half number. Start with our orange, about one number. We start our lemon, about one number. Budina, pinch only. And we'll be using kurma madu. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Dalam 100 gram pun cukup. This time we are going to do for you ice blend. Okay. Then we'll be taking some ice. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. You see, sometimes when we work very hard, such as myself, I do cooking show. Normally we stay for 12 hours, 13 hours, sometimes 14 hours working non-stop, you know, shooting, photo session and all these things. I feel very weak. So what I do sometimes, I just take my few pieces of kurma and I take 1 or maybe 2 tablespoons of good honey from Yemen. And within half an hour, I feel strong again. I feel my tamaga coming up again. No problem at all. This is, I'm telling you from my experience. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Okay, our ice blend should have siap. This ice blend, you can find it at Sultan Fresh to Go, at Saudagar Kurma. You can find it in any branches over there, inshallah. And we will be pouring this beautiful drink over here. Okay. Sultan Fresh to Go, they will be serving specialty drinks and all these ingredients is going to be fresh, insha Rabbil Alameen. Kalau you ada di Damansara or you ada di Penang or you ada TBS, Terminal Bus Station, you can visit over there and you can have a look. Our product also pun ada di sana. Chef Ahmad Baklava pun ada di sana. And banyak-banyak barang lah. Kosmetik ada. Kalau untuk perempuan dia nak cuci tangan ke, buy sabun, into kosmetik, kita ada habatus sauda sabun, kita ada macam-macam over there lah. Please pay us a visit and have a look over there and see what we can provide to your needs. Okay, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin, kita sudah buat minum ni. Now we will be showing you the moment of the truth. We'll be showing you the moment of the truth lah. We will be showing you the lasagna, inshaAllah. Thank you. Okay, one more tip. Kita ambil kitchen towel. Okay, so now what we do, we'll take all the oil from the surface. We'll make sure that everything is beautiful, not so greasy. Okay, inshallah, we'll be seeing you again for a new episode with a new method of cooking. Bersama saya, Chef Amar, Masa Dari Hati, Masa with Iman, with our main sponsor, Saudagar Kurma, www.saudagarkurma.com. Fi amanillah, wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh.